Namaste. This is Professor T. Subramaniam Naidu, Professor of Anthropology, former Dean and Director, Central University of Pondicherry. For the last 16 years, I have travelled widely from Great Nicobar Islands, working on the Champagne, to Central India, South India, Northeastern India, and Himalayan regions to work on the Raji tribe. So, it is almost the project took 16 years to complete. Why we need the documentation of the ethnographic films on particularly vulnerable tribes? Because the present day, the most important global issue is the rapid disappearance of the few remaining tribal population. The disappearance entails an irreversible loss of cultural institution and in many cases actual physical extinction of the food gatherers and hunting societies, which raises scientific and humanistic questions of the most urgent sort: how to save these aboriginal tribal populations. The present work on the particularly vulnerable tribal groups is based on the 40 years of my anthropological research. These particularly vulnerable tribal population are struggling hard for their survival because of the expansion of the civilization. In no time, these people may extinct from the planet, like the Great Andamanese of Andaman and Nicobar Islands. According to the Ministry of Tribal Affairs and Census of India, we have 705 tribes in India. Among them, 75 are vulnerable tribes called as particularly vulnerable tribal groups. My research findings suggest among them, 20 tribes are most vulnerable and need immediate action for their conservation. We have 500 individuals in 7 tribes and less than 5,000 individuals in 20 tribes. 10,000 to 50,000, 17 tribes, 50,000 above 13 tribes, and no census for 10 tribes. Observations also suggest that 4 tribes doesn't have census at all from the independence period, that is Gutob Gadaba, Kutiyakond, Bodo Parja, and Sutiya Barja tribes. The 2011 census shows 37 tribes doesn't have the census figures at all. The first documentation of the film started in the year 1994 with the financial support of Minister of Environment and Forest to work on the Andaman Islands. Then it was funded by Planning Commission, Government of India, UGC, DAD, Indian Council of Medical Research, New Delhi, and the family members. The experiences while working among the tribes cannot be forgotten during the field work. I have slept on the stones, having fire to escape from the elephants and tigers. Miles together walking in the deep jungle in Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Orissa, Chhattisgarh, Bihar, Jharkhand, Northeastern region and Himalayas, which are a really wonderful experience which no anthropologist or social scientist in the world might have experienced. The experiences with the Nexalites in the tribal areas in Andhra Pradesh, Orissa, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, and Madhya Pradesh cannot be forgotten. The visual documents of the 75 primitive tribes cover 215 hours of raw film on these tribes and more than 10,000 photographs. Each document is about 50 to 60 minutes, which provides the information on the way of life, of social organization, songs, dances, life cycle rituals, education, health, economy, and social organization, and the future requirements of the tribes, the health problems, the status of women, and the settlemental pattern. All these things were discussed in each documentary film. I feel myself, each documentary film is like a PhD thesis. Definitely, the documents of 75 primitive tribes, the documents also provide suggestions and advices how to save the vulnerable tribal population. I want to share the rich research experience with the people of India and wants to preserve this rich cultural heritage of Indian tribes for the future generations. The documents may be preserved in the institute libraries for the future generation and reference purposes. In India, we have 75 particularly vulnerable tribal groups. Among the 75 tribes, 14 tribes are inhabiting in the same state or in multiple states or in the adjacent states, having the same cultural way of life. So, for the documentation purpose, the same tribe inhabiting in different states considered as one unit for the documentation of the film. So, the total number of particularly vulnerable tribes films comes around 61 documentary films on 61 tribes. The present documents help in preserve the rich cultural heritage of the Indian tribes, and also the documents helps the administrators, policy makers, politicians and the people involved in the conservation of the particularly vulnerable tribal population, most particularly the students of anthropology, sociology, psychology, social work and those who prepare IAS administrative service examination. Definitely these documents will help in different ways for the research work and taking the competitive exams. The scholars may get the doubt how I have completed the massive research project. I have followed anthropological methodology in different ways. First, I have prepared the bibliographic references for each primitive tribe, and a separate file was maintained to store the data. The data, published, unpublished data and references were noted, and the author names and the scholars from different universities and institutions, their addresses and email contact numbers were also collected in the beginning. That is the first exercise which I have done. I have also identified the research scholars who have done research for their PhD in a particular tribe. I have contacted them and I have noted their addresses and the emails, and also taken their suggestions how to reach them and how to go to that particular tribe. A systematic plan was prepared to go ahead with the documentation. Before documenting the film, an ethnographic research was conducted on every particularly vulnerable tribes where they are concentrated and stayed in their villages. Complete data was collected and report was established, identified the investigators, identified the people who will help in enactment of the document, and also contacted the programmers who help in the tribal settlements for performing the dances, marriage ceremonies, death ceremonies, etc. The primary source data was collected by participant observation methodology, which is an important anthropological methodology, where we have identified the important cultural events of each tribe so that we can able to more focus on a particular aspect of the culture, so which will give the importance of the tribe and people can able to understand the rich cultural heritage of a particular tribe. The film collected was edited, dubbed, added voice, given references, added the data, and recorded by me in my own laboratory, in the department and also in the house. So, almost for the last 16 years, I have worked more than 10 hours every day apart from my classwork, research work and administrative work. So, I have sacrificed my entire life for this project. Whether you believe it or not, day and night, I have worked for this project. Based on my research experience, I observed these tribes are the first nations of India, that is, the original inhabitants of India. I have faced many problems in collection of the data, in documenting the film. Now, you can see what are the problems and how I can able to successful as an anthropologist to document the films on the primitive tribes. 60% of the particularly vulnerable tribes are inhabiting in the red corridor zones where the Naxalites are dominant in these areas. You can see the Gadchiroli, where is a core area, and also the Maoist areas where most of the Naxalites are occupied these territories. It is very difficult to go to these areas for doing the research. Most of the primitive tribes which have been covered or comes under the red corridor zone. So, always the life is under threat for doing research. However, it has been managed to do research in these populations. It became a challenging task for me to do research in these red corridor zones. Several times I faced life threatening, especially in the areas of Madhya Pradesh, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Bihar and Orissa. I have adopted different methods to approach the tribes through the NGOs, through the local professors and teachers who are working in these regions. I have faced great threat in working among the Asuru tribes of Netrahat region in Jharkhand. Then the Abujmaria tribe is one of the important area where I have faced a life threat. For the first time, I have worked in the core area for the Abujmaria documentation. Done research on Mandla and Dindori districts of Madhya Pradesh in studying Baiga tribe. Worked in Patalkot region in Madhya Pradesh for Bariya tribe. In West Bengal and Orissa borders for Birhor tribe. Chanchus of Nalamalai forest. Worked among the Dongriya Kond of Orissa in Malkangiri and Koraput regions. Worked in Hilkorawa, in Dumka and Gumla districts of Jharkhand. Lodha in West Bengal borders of Orissa. Maria Gond in Gadchiroli of Maharashtra, which is a very dangerous area. And Sauri Paharia in Jharkhand and Bihar. Saharia tribe of Bijapur districts in Chhattisgarh state. It is very difficult to work even in Orissa state among the Didai tribe, Kondareddis of Andhra Pradesh, the core area for Naxalites. Other tough areas of research are the Shompen tribe of Great Nicobar Island, Jarwa tribe of Middle and South Andaman, Riang tribe of Tripura, Maram Naga tribe of Manipur, and Raji tribe of Uttaranchal, that is on the foothills of Himalayas. Almost 16 years I have dedicated for documenting the films in searching the tribes in remote areas. That is why I called the series and developed the concept Man in Search of Man. For the successful of this project, I wanted to share with you the most important thing, that is, I never contacted any administrators or revenue officers or any other people concerned with the government except in Andaman and Nicobar Islands and working in Chhattisgarh region above Abuja Maria, where Abuja Maria also I am not able to get good response and help. I have taken the help of local NGOs, the professors of different universities and the scholars, students who are working on these tribal populations. So there was no wastage of time and time concern. Straight away I have gone to the field work with the help of the scholars and I have worked. That is the secret of my success in completion of this project. The prepared documents, reports and films were submitted to the concerned administrative officers of the state and also the ministries. The reports and the film documents helped in several ways for the administrators to take action for the development of the tribes, especially in Andaman Islands. I have submitted the reports on all Andaman tribes to the AAJVS. They have taken initiation and implemented my recommendations for conservation of the tribes of Andaman Islands. In the same way, in all the states, I have submitted the reports, not only the state government, but also the concerned ministries in central government. So, in this way also, my documents, my films, my research work helped the tribes in many ways. In appreciation of my research on Andaman and Nicobar Islands, in 1998, the Government of India and the Andaman administration given me the Commendation Award. And the reports prepared by me submitted to the different ministries, including the SCST Commission and Lok Sabha Speaker Sangmaji and the Minister Farooq Singh Kulaste, Health Minister, and the Minister of Tribal Affairs, Minister of Tribal Affairs, Joel Worom. The documents are not made professionally, they are made indigenously in my own lab. To do professional documentation films, it is very expensive and also it requires a lot of technology. And moreover, it is very difficult to take the research team and technical persons to the interior tribal areas. Finally, I would like to thank all the people who have helped me in successful completion of this documentation of ethnographic films on 75 PVTGs in India. I am thankful to the professors, teachers, scholars, students, NGOs of the local areas, taxi drivers, petty shopkeepers, tea shop keepers, and also the people, tribal leaders who helped me in a big way in conducting the research and documenting the film. For the cinema topography, I have taken the help of my research scholars, Dr. G. Palaniswamy, Dr. Dash, Dr. Sasi Kumar, and my wife Anusuya, my son Darshan, and my daughter Deepti. So I am thankful to all of you for watching this episode of inaugural speech on the Primitive Tribes films launching. I request you to subscribe to this channel for getting more information on cultural heritage of Indian people, especially the tribes of India. If you like, you forward it to your friends and relatives to watch these movies. every Friday one film will be broadcasted. You can wait for the films from today onwards. It starts. Thank you very much for listening and having spent good amount of time with me. If you have any questions and other things, you can directly post me in my link or write to my email address. Thank you very much. Thank you.